Welcome back. In our last video, we looked at the biophysical processes that help shape the Earth's surface. In this video, we will look at tectonic plates that flow and shape the land. Plate tectonics is a theory which outlines the movement of the lithosphere, since tectonic processes on the Earth started 3.3 billion to 3.5 billion years ago. Continental drift, which was established in the early 20th century, is the foundation for this theory. Continental drift is the theory that the Earth's continents have migrated, relative to one another, throughout geologic time, giving the appearance of drifting across the ocean floor. Abraham Hertelius originally proposed the idea that continents could have drifted in 1596. Alfred Wegener expanded on the notion in 1912, but many dismissed his hypothesis. Arthur Holmes later established mantle convection. The theory of plate tectonics, which explains how continents move by riding on plates of the Earth's lithosphere, has subsequently supplanted the concept of continental drift. The lithosphere is the planet's hard outermost shell and contains tectonic plates. Earth's lithosphere contains 7 or 8 main plates, depending on how they are classified, plus many smaller plates. Tectonic plates comprise oceanic lithosphere and thicker continental lithosphere, each of which is topped by its own type of crust. The thickness of the oceanic lithosphere typically ranges from around 6 kilometers at mid-ocean ridges to over 100 kilometers near subduction zones. Continental lithosphere is around 200 kilometers thick. However, this varies between basins, mountain ranges, and continents' stable cratonic interiors. Underneath the lithosphere, the asthenosphere exists. The lithosphere is colder and more rigid, whereas the asthenosphere is warmer and more fluid. As the lithosphere is warmer and more rigid, the tectonic plates float and move on top of the liquid-like asthenosphere. Plate movements can vary from 10 to 160 millimeters per year. The Mid-Atlantic Ridge, for example, grows at roughly the same rate as fingernails, whilst the Nazca plate shrinks at roughly the same rate as hair grows. A plate boundary is the point at which two plates come together. Plate boundaries correlate with geological events, like earthquakes, and the formation of topographic features including mountains, volcanoes, mid-ocean ridges, and oceanic trenches. The bulk of active volcanoes on the planet are along plate boundaries, with the Ring of Fire being the most active and well-known. Divergent, convergent, and transform boundaries are the three types of plate boundaries. Divergent boundaries develop when two plates separate from one another. They occur because of seafloor spreading in zones of ocean-to-ocean rifting, creating new ocean basins. Divergent boundaries in zones of continent-to-continent rifting may cause the formation of new ocean basins when the continent divides and expands. Convergent boundaries arise when two plates slide towards each other. The thick oceanic lithosphere plunges into the less dense continent during zones of ocean-to-continent subduction. An example of this is the Cascade Mountain Range in the United States of America. Older, colder, denser crust slides beneath less dense crust at zones of ocean-to-ocean subduction. An example of this are the islands of Japan. Ocean basin closure can occur on continent-to-continent boundaries because of collisions between masses of continental lithosphere. An example of this occurred when the Indian landmass collided with the Eurasian plate. This process created the Himalayas and the tallest mountain today, Mount Everest. Transform boundaries occur when two plates grind past one another along transform faults, where plates are neither produced nor destroyed. Along a fault, strong earthquakes can occur. An example of a transform boundary is the San Andreas Fault in California. This is the last video in this series on landforms and landscapes. After watching this video, you now have a deep understanding on what plate tectonics are and how they help shape the Earth. The Earth is always changing, and it will continue to do so.